Your commentator is Joe O'Brien. The United States goes to war. Offensive war, the kind of battle in which America and Americans always excel. Japan's treacherous attack upon Pearl Harbor flares like a battle cry as fighting men of the United States surge forward determined to bring the war to the Japs. American ships, planes, and guns are rushed in ever-increasing numbers to meet the enemy. Meet the enemy shot for shot, but with a superior efficiency and a unified spirit, with a will and determination to win, to pay back in flaming installments for Japan's evil deception. Troop transports plow westward in the Pacific, guarded in the air, protected on all sides by the United States Navy. Sailors, soldiers, and civilian workers are rushed to reinforce the defenses of Pearl Harbor. Soldiers for United States outposts, sailors for the Pacific Fleet, Marines for land and sea duty, civilian workers for reconstruction. Great ships, once luxury vessels, now turned over to the grim business of war, turn their bows into the direction of war, carrying necessary supplies, men, and equipment to make America's far-flung offensive possible and lasting. In the vast, trackless Pacific, America's Western Fleet heads southward. Battleships, cruisers, destroyers, aircraft carriers, and men. Pay back Pearl Harbor is the war cry. Tense watchfulness in hostile waters as our offensive fleet patrol plows through the southern sea under tropical skies. Battle stations are made ready to launch the first American naval offensive of the war. A United States aircraft carrier steams ahead. While below decks, Vice Admiral William Halsey Jr. and his aides map details of the surprise attack. Their battle objective is the Jap-controlled Marshall and Gilbert Islands, halfway between Hawaii and Australia in the South Pacific. Final orders for the intrepid airmen who will carry the attack to the enemy shores, messengers sent by Uncle Sam to deliver devastating blows to Japan. Now from the carrier's radio room comes the command, "Stand by for orders." It echoes to the navigators on the bridge. And down into the engine room, bells ring and the indicator moves to full speed ahead. Motors whirl as the swarm of American planes makes ready for the initial blanket of aerial thunder. Arming crews rush bombs to the monster aircraft. Everyone has a job to do, a serious job for America. Now they are almost within sight of the islands mandated to Japan by the League of Nations, almost within range of the bases from which the Japs attacked Wake Island. Planes aboard a cruiser are catapulted to take their place in the aerial battle line. Then comes the order, "Fire!" On the horizon are seen the dull green tops of coconut palms as signals flash a hit. a modern Japanese light cruiser and an aircraft carrier suffer direct hits in the relentless bombing. These, with 14 other Jap warships, are sunk before Nippon's fighter planes get into action. And on the shore beyond, air bases, hangars, and key shore positions are wrecked in the brilliant surprise attack. Dense black smoke billows up from destroyed ammunition dumps. Storage tanks and warehouses are blown to bits as hit after hit is scored along the entire shoreline. Jap planes appear, but too late. United States gunners have the range and pelt the sky full of hot steel. During the battle, 41 Jap planes are destroyed. Two large seaplanes, 15 fighting planes, 21 bombers, and 3 patrol planes. There's a hit, and down the enemy comes, plunging into the tropical seas. A continuous thunderstorm of anti-aircraft and machine gun fire meets the Jap airmen. The skies are filled with shrapnel. Here is a Jap bomber put out of business by Yankee marksmanship. The enemy airman points his failing plane at the deck of an aircraft carrier. A gunner sends a burst into the bomber, and it crashes into the sea. Here is sky war as rarely seen. Six fortified enemy bases get a taste of Uncle Sam's fighting temper. According to naval experts, this is the pattern of the war we must fight, eventually in Japan's home islands themselves. All military installations and hangars are destroyed, and shore batteries silenced, radio towers blasted, and shore facilities leveled to the ground. Oil tanks explode, the Marshall Islands aflame. Homeward they turn as the smoke of battle rises. Homeward to report, paid, first installment on Pearl Harbor.